Welcome to the Prepped and Polished podcast, the podcast that empowers you to take control of your education, featuring weekly interviews with influencers in the world of education, as well as tutoring tips, lessons, and updates. And now, here's your host, Alexis Avila.
And welcome back to the Prepped and Polished podcast. This is your host, Alexis Avila, and this is episode 146. Make sure to join our community. You can find us on SoundCloud, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Instagram, and YouTube. Just type Prepped and Polished and you'll find us. And go to PreppedandPolished.com for more info and sign up for our free ACT essay course on the front page of our site. That's PreppedandPolished.com. If you need tutoring, you can reach me at 781-753-9951 or shoot me an email, info@PreppedandPolished.com. Have a question or reaction during or after the podcast, submit your question to radio at PreppedandPolished.com. Today on episode 146, I'm talking to guest DJ Shree. He's host of the popular iTunes podcast Mobile DJ Tips, a weekly show that interviews influential DJs from around the world to share marketing, music, business knowledge. Previous guests have included Oprah's DJ. DJ Shree graduated from Rutgers University with a double bachelor's in economics and public health. On today's show, DJ Shree shares with us his tips for any teen who wants to pursue an exciting career in music. So let's get right to our guest today. This is episode number 146 with DJ Shree. DJ Shree, thanks for coming on the Prepped and Polished podcast. How are you doing today?
Alex, it's a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Can you please share with us how you became a nationally recognized DJ and host of the Mobile DJ Tips podcast?
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, thank you very much for that introduction. And, you know, definitely I say that very humbly. You know, there's many DJs. I know you had DJ Arai on your podcast as well. So, you know, DJing, there's definitely a lot of DJs that are nationally known. But today, yes, I am a podcast host for one of the only DJ podcasts available called Mobile DJ Tips. And, you know, really that was just a process of trial and error and learning what works and mainly building a community based on a similar passion in the music industry.
That's awesome. And what types of services do you provide on your mobiledj.com website?
So we kind of hope to be a one-stop shop for all types of DJs. So within the DJing world, there's many different things going on. You know, you have your mixing and scratching, and then you have your crowd interaction, you know, how to actually, you know, entertain, right? That's what DJs do at the end of the day. We entertain. We don't just play music. But, you know, there's many different things going on. How to talk on the mic, emceeing, how to put on a light show. You know, many DJs are also expanding into that. But, you know, we offer classroom courses in each of these kinds of things. But overall, it really comes down to how to teach somebody. And this is what the podcast is about as well. Although we focus on the music industry, I think the biggest take listeners get is how to take their passion for whatever that is and how to run with it in today's age.
That's awesome. It's all about the passion. So what are some of the biggest myths people have about DJs?
Oh, man, there's too many to name. Where do you want me to start?
Well, myth one, maybe, you know, being a DJ is definitely like a part-time job where you get a party here and there. I don't make a lot of money living in your friend's basement.
I like that one. So definitely you can become a full-time DJ. That's something that I've been doing for the past few years. And scaling a company, becoming an entrepreneur, that's all very much possible in the DJ world. And especially since you brought up the, you know, the basement DJs, I like that you brought that up, actually, because there's a lot of people out there that are doing that currently. They're making mixes. They're putting them on SoundCloud, iTunes, Spotify. And they might be in the basement. They might be in that area where they want to go out. They want to make more money. They want to play out for people, not just, you know, their own friends and family. And that's what we provide a resource to, because there are a lot of DJs, unfortunately, that don't get their talent shared with the world. And that's why we created Mobile DJ Tips in 2015 to give a resource to those individuals where they can take their talent and then learn how to mainly grow a business and grow a career from it.
Wow. How did you use your college education to ultimately landed you a career in DJing and podcasting and entrepreneurship?
So, again, I love your questions, by the way, Alexis. They go right to the core. And, you know, I love the podcast as well. So I'm very honored to be, you know, part of the community today. But
thanks.
I would say college truly has, you know, it's hard to a lot of let's start here. There's a lot of controversy on what is the role of college in entrepreneurship. And, you know, even right now, there's a lot of different influential people saying, don't go to college if you want to be an entrepreneur. Or some people are saying, go to college and you can still become an entrepreneur. You know, my background is I went to Rutgers University, the State College of New Jersey, graduated with a double major in economics and public health, got into the BS MBA program with the Master's in Business Administration. And, really, where did college fit into what I do on a daily basis with music and everything? I think that outside of college, a lot of people focus on, you know, oh, it has to be the textbook, you know, what does economics and public health have to do with DJing? And it honestly doesn't have much to do with anything. But what it really taught me, and this is what I like to focus on anytime someone asks me, should I go to college if I want to be an entrepreneur? I would say go to college because there's so many different things that you will learn from college that it's outside of the classroom, it's outside of the professors. You know, you're going to get to grow up with people. You know, you're going there during a crucial time in your life, and you're going to get to grow with people. Socially, you're going to grow, you know, and personally, you're going to grow. So where does it play into my day-to-day? I mean, I've learned so much about the world just from going to college. You know, it wasn't just sitting in the classroom, but, you know, seeing the different types of people, seeing how they, you know, really mature, going from, what is it, like 18 to 21 or yeah, 18 to 22 approximately, you know, seeing how people mature, seeing how people think differently about the world, and mainly making my own perspective of the world. So, you know, I'm a big pro college guy, especially for entrepreneur or not.
Absolutely. And in many ways, I think that the big colleges get a little bit of a bad rep, but you know, when you go to a big college, you know, I went to Michigan, you went to Rutgers, it's a pretty big school, even more the merrier, more people, more diversity, you learn from more different types of people. So that's why I love going to a big college.
100%. I could not agree more.
So you interviewed Oprah's DJ. Congrats. Was wondering, what were a few takeaways you got from that conversation?
So that is correct. Her name is Cynthia Maloran, better known as DJ Cherish the Love. And she's based in New York City. We've had many great DJs, you know, not to discredit any of the other DJs we've had on the podcast. You know, some of them are, you know, for example, on the first show, we had the 3-year president of the New Jersey DJ Association, Greg Holman. Recently, we interviewed the 3-time DJ of the Year champion, Jack Bermio. Multiple best-selling authors, Stacey Zeman, Michael Walter. And I realize I might be just name-dropping here for many people that don't know the DJ world. But overall, I think during the podcast, what I've been learning personally, and I think a lot of the feedback I've gotten from the listeners is it's very inspiring, not only listening to my voice and, you know, understanding what I'm trying to say, but it's very inspiring to think that, you know, creative arts, thinking that you can create a life being in the creative arts industry. You know, people don't really think about that. You know, I know when you had DJ Irai on your podcast for episode 36, I believe, he was talking about he's from a Jamaican background, and he was saying his parents gave him two options. Do you want to be a doctor or a lawyer? And my background, you know, if you can't tell, DJ Shree is Indian. And for me, you know, being from an Indian immigrant family, I was given one option. It was either a doctor or doctor. So I didn't have much of a choice. And, you know, thinking that, wow, you can do something outside of the standard medical, law, you know, business. You can do something, branch out, go into a creative arts industry and actually make a living from it. And I think that's the biggest takeaway that I've gotten from all of the podcast guests, including DJ Cherish.
That's amazing. So for teens who want to pursue a career in music, what advice would you have for them?
Thank you for bringing that up. I think anybody that wants to pursue a career in music or arts, don't worry about, you know, what society tries to tell you. I mean, of course, listen to all the different perspectives. You know, don't just tell your parents, oh, you don't understand. If your parents are working a corporate job or they might be doing something else, listen to all types of perspectives. You know, being in the arts industry, one of the things that we pride ourselves in is being open-minded. I mean, DJs, naturally, people always ask me, what's your favorite type of music? I say every genre is my favorite type of music. So you have to be open-minded, and that translates into your life as well. So if you're a teen listening to this, you know, definitely Alexis gives a lot of great advice on a weekly basis, and But mainly, keep an open mind. Stay open to different opportunities. When you go into college, you know, don't be afraid to test out different majors. If you walk in undecided, don't think that you're going to be a failure. You know, look at different classes. Take an econ class. Take a science class. Take this class. Take that class. Experiment. And even though your passion, even though you might walk in saying, oh, my passion is music, or my passion is, you know, something in the creative side, don't be afraid to, you know, at least challenge yourself a little bit. Go take an accounting class. I've taken Financial Accounting 101. I didn't like it, but I can say I passed, you know, and, you know, it definitely gave me perspective. So anybody that, you know, whether or not you're in the creative or not side, you know, don't be afraid to experiment.
That's awesome. Now, what are some things teens do wrong when, you know, they aspire to be a recording artist or pursue a career in music?
Mm-hmm. I think they try to do too much too fast. And okay. Let me explain by that. I'm a pretty young guy as well. I don't think that you can't be an overachiever based on your age, right? Age is just a number in my book. But I think when I say do too much too fast, I mean, don't fake it. You know, a lot of people throw around this word, fake it till you make it. And I actually hate that. I think that you should be genuine, be honest, go out there, show them what you got. You know, if you're trying to make an industry, you know, in the DJ industry, a lot of people ask me, hey, Shree, you know, I'm DJing in the basement, you know, just for me and the brick wall that's next to me. And how do I start booking events and, you know, start playing out for people at nightclubs, lounges, or even private events, corporate events, weddings, get on the radio. And I say, anytime you talk to a client, be honest with them, be genuine. And that's how you're going to sell your services, because people can tell when you're honest. And that, you know, that's obviously that's a lesson that's obviously people have to go through themselves to realize that. But, you know, of course, take this with a grain of salt. But I believe when you're an honest person and you go out there and you say, hey, I'm a DJ, I love what I do, I love mixing, but to be honest, this might be one of the first events I book with you, clients will actually respect that. And they will say, you know what? Do you have any mixes online I can listen to? And sooner or later, one client's going to be like, you know what? I like your style. Let's do this. And so be honest. You know, the mistake a lot of people go out there is they're doing too much too fast. Be honest, be humble, and just be genuine.
That's awesome. We kind of alluded to it before, but do you need a college education to pursue a career in music, or, you know, or not? And if so, what types of colleges should teens' parents look out for if their child's considering a career?
Oof, very great question. So I wish I kind of knew that I wanted to go into this. Like I mentioned, my parents always wanted me to push, go into the medical world. So I went to Rutgers, which has a fantastic pre-medical program. But I still became, you know, a DJ. So I personally am not too familiar with all the different music colleges, but I would look out for online resources. You know, Mobile DJ Tips has many things on YouTube, and obviously iTunes, our podcast. So if you're interested in the music world, check out our podcast, check out our YouTube videos. But more than anything else, I would say look out for any types of resources. You know, when you're applying to colleges, look out for clubs and organizations. That was something that attracted me to Rutgers as well. You know, I play drums. I play an Indian style of drum called a dhol. And what attracted me personally, although my parents liked the pre-medical program at Rutgers, I liked that they had a dhol team, a drum team there. So that's what attracted me. So any college you apply to, I mean, this is just my personal perspective, look out for the clubs and organizations, because that's where you're going to meet like-minded people. And I think that's where you'll learn a lot outside of the classroom.
That's awesome. So what's the future hold for DJ Shree? Like, what types of projects are you currently working on?
So currently what we're working on, you know, my day-to-day challenges have been changing recently. We're seeing a lot of growth with the podcast. So mainly today what I'm facing is making sure that we can give quality content and keep the podcast fresh. Because up until now, you know, the podcast has had great guests. And I think the beauty of podcasting, and Alexis, maybe you can tell me more about this because you've been in this a little bit longer than I have, but I've noticed that a lot of people are sharing almost the secrets to success, and I want to make sure that we're presenting it in a fresh way every time, because it's actually kind of funny, and Alexis, I really want to take your perspective on this, that the secrets to success that everyone talks about, there's like a few things, like a few major things that keep coming up with all my conversations with people, and you know, I want to make sure that people not get bored, but also they have a fresh perspective on the same key to success. So would you say, I don't know, Alexis, what do you think about that?
100% agree, because the greats, the guests that we have on are the all-stars. They're the people who have an interesting story, been successful, and they all, there is definitely like a unifying trait that all successful people can have. And that's why the last question I always ask for some advice, words of wisdom. And the words of wisdom, I definitely see a lot of overlaps for my guests. A lot of secrets to success. So completely agree. I mean, it's actually quite a pleasant surprise having done the podcast and learning so much from these people. So,
Yeah, kudos to you. I mean, you've been doing it a lot longer than I have. So yeah, kudos to you. It's definitely, and I still love the show. I was listening to like even your recent episodes, the tutoring tips. So it's good. Like you're definitely, providing really fresh content. And I aspire to, listen to shows like yours, shows that are in this industry that are keeping it fresh, giving fresh content, but keeping the perspectives. Even though we know that there's like a few major things that teens need to do to get into college, there's a way to say it and there's a way to say it to different people so they understand it in a different way. So much kudos to you.
Thank you. So the teenage years is an exciting and overwhelming time in one's life. To any teens listening to us today, any words of wisdom before they cross the bridge to young adulthood?
Listen more than you talk. I think, and I say that very humbly, I've been through the teenage years and, people will say, oh, teens are know-it-alls. I don't think that. I think that the key to success, and if you're trying to do anything, when you're going into the adult years, the people that are adults right now and the ones that are a little bit, one step ahead of everybody else, the only difference that really comes down to, we're talking about secrets to success and, the key advice that we keep hearing. Really what I always understand from everybody is they had mentors. And it's not that, oh, this person, signed a contract with me and he said he's my mentor. No, mentor can be anybody, right? Keep your ears open. Listen to every single thing you hear, from this podcast and anywhere else, any conversation you have with anybody, anybody can be your mentor. It's not an official relationship. So any teens going into the adult years, just keep your ears open. Even if you're talking to a cashier, at Chipotle, like listen to what's going on in their day. Find out, oh, this is what the struggle's like. When you wake up, you have to do this, this, and this. Like, find out, listen to everybody's story. Keep your ears open. And then when you go into adulthood, you'll be that much more wise.
Yeah, that's amazing advice. And that's exactly my point. Like the greats usually say that. So, so you're one of them. It's a lot of just like, being humble and not being scared to listen to different perspectives. Not a lot of people have that skill, and that's why not everybody's great. So I completely think that that advice is amazing. And, man, you got quite a future.
Hey, thank you very much. Alexis, you wouldn't believe this, and to all the teens listening to this, I openly share my age and I have no problem doing it, but you called me one of the greats and I don't even think I'm worthy of that title yet, but I'm not too far off, from a lot of your audience. I'm actually only 23 years old, so but the only thing I can say that's vouched for me up until this point and gotten to me where I am is I listen a lot. And I listen to a lot of different podcasts and like yours, and I listen to a lot of people that are a little bit ahead of me, and I find out, okay, this is what he's facing. And I love the questions you ask, what challenges are you facing? That's such an interesting question because it gives such great perspective to all the teenagers. They get to start thinking ahead, like, oh, hey, this guy's this old and this is what he's worrying about in a day to day. So they can start, strategizing at a younger age to make sure that they don't fall into that trap. So it's good.
That's awesome. Well, DJ Shree, thanks for coming on the Prepped and Polished podcast, and really appreciate your time.
Yeah, thank you, Alexis. Thank you for having me. It's been an honor.
And this wraps up our show today. This was episode number 146 with DJ Shree. To connect with DJ Shree and sign up for his course, go to www.mobiledjtips.com. mobiledjtips.com. I hope you enjoyed episode number 146 with DJ Shree. Make sure to go back and listen to my interview with the world's hottest DJ, DJ Irie, on episode 36. The title of that podcast was Using the Main Stage to Empower At-Risk Youth. That was episode 36. Tune in soon to hear our next podcast, episode number 147. It will be our next Tutoring Tips podcast. To access episode 146 with DJ Shree and all of our podcast episodes, head over to preppedandpolished.com/podcast or go to soundcloud.com/preppedandpolished. Thank you for joining us on the Prepped and Polished podcast. Now go out there and take control of your education.
You've been listening to the Prepped and Polished podcast. For more information, check out preppedandpolished.com. Also, you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for listening. Class dismissed.